I'm here at Plastic Playland. How cute! Did you know that every time you eat, drink, and inhale, you consume tiny microscopic pieces of plastic? Yay! Don't panic. Look at Professor Cuddlesworth here. While some of the plastic leaves your body when you exhale or go to the bathroom, the rest remains inside of you. Wow! Don't panic. Everything is fine. Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. This parasitic plastic discovery set off alarm bells in the scientific community, and researchers set out to determine exactly how much we are ingesting and if it's causing any harm. Microplastics are particles smaller than 5 millimeters that have broken off from larger plastic objects. These tiny particles are everywhere, in water, dust, clothes, produce, agriculture, you name it. You are a warehouse of water bottle bits. This is one reason why it's hard to determine exactly how much we consume. And no, it's not a credit card size amount each week. That study has been debunked. The actual amount depends on where you live, what you eat, where your water comes from, and a number of other factors. In one study on the American diet, researchers estimated that each person consumes between 39,000 and 52,000 microplastic particles each year from food and drink alone. When they took breathing into account, these numbers jumped to 74,000 and 122,000 particles a year. And if you only drink water from plastic bottles, add another 90,000 particles to that. Worst case scenario, this translates to about 580 microplastic particles a day. That sure sounds like a lot, but again, some of it will find its way out. But yes, not all of it leaves. Scientists have found microplastics everywhere in the human body, including livers, hearts, placentas, testicles, limb joints, blood vessels, bone marrow, and even brains. That's right, your noggin. This means that these particles can leave the lungs and GI tract and enter tissues and cells. So what does this mean for your health? So far, researchers haven't definitively proven that microplastics cause health problems in humans, but they have identified some red flags. For instance, some of these chemicals in plastics are known to disrupt the endocrine system, which makes hormones that control growth and development, metabolism, mood, and some aspects of reproduction. In addition, animal studies have indicated that microplastics can cause oxidative damage, DNA damage, and changes in gene activity, all of which are known risk factors for cancer. And a recent study on humans found that patients with microplastics in their corroded artery plaque were more likely to have a heart attack, stroke, or die compared to those who didn't. By now, I'm sure you're all wondering how to avoid microplastics. Well, I'm sorry to say it's not easy, but you can start by using only glass, wood, and metal items when you cook and eat, getting a HEPA filter, and buying clothes made from natural fibers. The truth is, though, plastic is everywhere. Plastic Playland is actually just Earth, and you can never leave this theme park. But if we really want to be plastic-free, we need to figure out ways to end our reliance on it and clean up the existing plastic pollution in the sea, land, and air. And also hold corporations accountable, because why is it your fault for any of this? Newsflash, it's not. These companies made you believe that you were responsible for recycling everything and handling all of it. It's their product, and they should share most, if not all, of the blame. Okay, goodbye. So do you think you can survive in a plastic-free world? Do you think all of this is overhyped? Let me know in the comment section below, or tell me what we should talk about next. Want to watch even more Life Noggin? Click here to watch this video or this video YouTube thinks you'll enjoy. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.